Hey, it's Patrick here from thegarageBandguide.com. In this video, I'm taking a closer look at GarageBand's arrangement markers and arrangement track, and how you can use them to improve your recording and mixing workflow. Now, I know arrangement markers doesn't sound like the most exciting feature in the world, but using them to their full potential can actually really make your life much, much easier. So, in a nutshell, you can add arrangement markers to a project to create different sections like a verse, intro, and chorus, and then move these sections in the track area to rearrange your project. So, when you're setting this up, the first arrangement marker begins at the start of the project, and each additional arrangement marker you add starts at the end of the previous one with no space in between. You'll get the most use out of these arrangement markers if you add them to every section of your project so that you can rearrange the entire project as and when you need to. So arrangement markers are 8 bars long by default. You can resize them by hovering over the edge of a marker until the resize icon appears. Then just drag and drop to the size that you want. You can also rename your markers to reflect its place in the project. So if we have a look at this project here, I have a verse, bridge, and chorus already put together. So here's how that sounds. If I drag the bridge to behind the chorus, the verse will play back straight into the chorus. A good example of how this can be especially useful would be if you have an entire project pretty much completed, but think that actually you want to add a kick-ass intro. Instead of going through the arduous process of selecting all your individual regions and then dragging and dropping them into just the right place, you can simply record your intro in an arrangement marker at the end of the rest of your project and then drag it to the start of your project. Much easier. Another thing to note, if you add arrangement markers to a project and then add a drummer track, drummer regions for each arrangement marker are added, with the length and name of the regions corresponding to the markers, which is very, very useful and saves you a ton of time. So there you have it. That's an overview of how to get the most from GarageBand's arrangement markers and arrangement track. If you found this video helpful, leave a like. I really do appreciate it. If you're not subscribed already, then now's a great time to do so. We've got brand new GarageBand videos coming your way every single week. And don't forget to hit the wee bell icon there to make sure that you don't miss a thing. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.